You may have read or heard somewhere that a home should look like you. It simply means when you decorate and style your home yourself, you give it a soul and a character that represents you. And when that happens, you become more connected to your space and become more aware of your surroundings. And if you're looking for some inspiration, this is the video for you. In today's video, I'm going to show you three different ways to style and decorate your kitchen countertop. Since the pandemic hit, we all have been spending much more time in our kitchens than usual, and more so with the focus being on one's health and increasing the immunity. Your kitchen countertop goes through a lot throughout the day with cutting, chopping and whatnot. So let's show some love and decorate our kitchen countertops, but in a way that it still serves its purpose but looks nice and beautiful at the same time. But just before I head towards my kitchen, if you're new here, hi, my name is Astha. I make home and lifestyle videos on this channel, which includes cleaning, organizing, meal prep, DIYs, etc. So if you're into all that, please do consider subscribing. Now let's get started with the video. This is my kitchen countertop, not very big, but I do like to decorate it a little bit and also have some frequently used things out on the counter. On this left side here, I do most of my chopping and mixing. So I'm going to be styling mostly this corner here. So for the first one, I'm using this beautiful wooden tray to create a vignette on this corner. Vignette is basically a cluster of things put together to create a pleasing focal point, which is what I intend to do. So on this tray here, I'm putting a white ceramic jar with my spatulas at the back. And then two more of these holders to put some more of my kitchen tools. Notice that these are all different heights. Then I'm putting another jar with this beautiful pattern on the side here. And in the center here, I'm putting a glass bottle with a plant in it. And I'm also putting my oil and ghee containers here. On the left side, I'm placing my cutting board and my mortar and pestle. And on the other side, I'm keeping this board, which has this really nice coat that I love. And a cute little plant next to it to give it company. All the things that I've placed here are in different heights and different patterns. So you see colors going from white and ivory to different shades of woods. And the plants add a nice contrast against this neutral background. Against this back wall, I'm keeping these glass jars with sugar and tea. You must have seen these many times in my videos. On the other side of the counter, I keep my mixer grinder, and I've also kept this cup and saucer planter along with this wooden bird bowl. I also added this beautiful hanging plant on this side to complete the look. And this is how the final look came out. So I really like how it turned out. Since the tray that I used is really big, I was able to keep a lot of stuff in it that I need very frequently in my kitchen. And a tray also makes it very easy to clean whenever I want. I just have to move the tray and clean it all up. Also, the addition of these small plants add a lot of freshness and charm to the decor. To create this second vignette, I'm using this extra cutting board that I have, and I'm using these traditional pickle burny jars to keep my spatulas and knives, etc. You can also use one of the jars to keep things like any of your dry spices like I have here. The key is to use odd number of things to decorate or style anything. You might have heard of this before as rule of threes or rule of thirds in decorating and interior designing, which basically says that the things arranged in odd numbers are more appealing, memorable and effective than even numbered. Because when you see an odd number of things, your eyes are forced to move around more, which makes for a more interesting visual experience. Even though 3 seems to be the magic number, but 5, 7, 9, etc. work nicely as well.
So I'm keeping my cutting board here and layering it up with this board which has some kitchen related quotes written on it, and then putting a planter in front of them to create another small trio here. You can also use two different kinds of cutting board to create this layered look. On this side here, I'm using one of these wooden coasters to keep my mortar and pestle. And then at the back there, I'm keeping this very interesting wooden pattern stamp sort of a tool. It's very, very traditional, and it's used to create patterns on the sweets. It was a gift from my mother-in-law, and I really like it as a decor piece also. Then I'm also keeping this bird wooden bowl to keep garlic there. The best part about kitchen decor is that you can actually use your food, spices and tools to double up as decor pieces. On the right hand side here, I'm using another one of these coats as a background, and then using a coaster to keep my oil and ghee containers. I'm also adding this little plant here to fill the gap, and I put this jute fabric around the bottle to go with the theme. With that, we are done with our second look. In this particular look, I love that it's very, very clean. Things are not concentrated just in one place, but are, you know, spread out throughout the counter. And they still look very, very neatly organized and well kept. And these Verni jars are definitely adding a lot of aesthetic to the whole space. You can also use these frames and boards that I've kept as backgrounds to pin up your recipe cards whenever you need to refer any recipe. This whole style makes me reminisce of the Indian summer, with its warm colors and pickle jars on display. It makes me really nostalgic about my childhood. Moving on to our third and final style, this look is going to be more modern yet whimsical. For this, I'm using this beautiful raisin cake stand, which actually has a crack on it now. So I'm keeping it in the corner, and then I'm placing this white ceramic jug that I have at the back, and I'm going to put this artificial plant inside it so that the plant beautifully trails down the cake stand. Then I'm keeping it very minimal by just keeping my oil and ghee containers along with this small glass jar with salt in it and a spoon to use with it. Now I'm placing a round cutting board on the left side, keeping with the soft and flowy feel of this look. Then in the front, I'm keeping my spatulas and this glass jar with walnuts inside it. I like how the colors stand out with the background here. Now I'm placing this beautiful pink color airtight jar which I got from Chumbak store. It looks very decorative and you can actually store anything inside it. And then I'm keeping this white ceramic holder that I have to store some of my tools and knives. And this beautiful owl shaped planter that I have from Chumbak again. And I'm just going to be using it to clip some clips or rubber bands that I use in the kitchen. This looked so pretty, I had to click some pictures for Instagram. On the other side, I'm using this hand-painted wooden tray that I got a long time back from one of the exhibitions. And then I'm keeping my sugar and tea containers, which also have this very whimsical vintage vibe to them. And then I'm keeping my mortar and pestle also along with it. So this kind of gels with the whole look. This look is definitely more decorative than the other two looks. It will be suitable for any of the festivals or any special occasions, or if you like, just to amp up the feel-good vibe in your kitchen. Styling any place in a particular way is a very personal choice, and everything makes a lot more sense when you are connected to your sense of style and something that feels very, very right in your heart. I I hope you guys liked all the three looks. Let me know in the comment box which was your favorite look. I personally cannot decide on one.
If you like this video, please like, share and comment, and do not forget to subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get notified whenever I post my next video. Do follow me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is Astha_Jaiswal31. I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.